class. Please welcome our new student.
Hi, what's your name?
I'm Samira.
Where are you from?
We moved from Allen.
Where are your parents from?
Oh, they're from Houston and Dallas.
I mean before that.
What? I don't get it.
Well, is your dad Chinese?
Oh, no, he's not.
So, is that guy your nanny?
No, that's my dad.
Well, what are you?
Seriously, this again? Why do I have to be so different from everyone else? I never know what to say. Maybe I should just ask my parents.
Well, I grew up in St. Louis and moved to Texas in high school. I always stood out growing up in the 70s and 80s as a first-generation Asian American. My dad's family was pretty poor in Taiwan, and my parents had very little when they arrived in the US, so we grew up with very few luxuries. I mean, we did have food and clothing, but I had to wear my sister's hand-me-downs. Growing up, my parents always stressed the importance of education as an investment in our future.
I grew up in Houston, which was actually a very diverse city, even in the 1980s. So I didn't really stand out that much because in my school, there were kids from all over the world. Houston has a very large Indian American community, so I got to experience a lot of aspects of Indian culture. But when my parents first came to the U.S., they had to leave everything behind, their family, their friends, their language, their customs. But they always maintained their belief in the importance of studying hard and working hard as well. You should probably talk to your grandparents to learn more about your history.
We left Taiwan in 1960s because it had a lot of political unrest, corruption, and oppression. At that time, America has a lot of opportunity and wealth, and President John F. Kennedy was trying to attract world's top science students for the space race and also for the U.S. military.
When we came to the United States, even though the culture was very different for us, we were respected and appreciated in our field because of our technical expertise. Immigration officers were very helpful back then when we accidentally missed the deadline of renewing documents.
After having green cards for several years, they encouraged us to get a U.S. citizenship, which we finally did in 1976.
I moved to Michigan from India in 1967, right after I got married. We stood out so much back then that they interviewed us on the radio. In the 60s, there was so little cultural diversity, we had to drive 200 miles all the way to Chicago just to get the fresh garlic and ginger.
I came to the U.S. in 1962 to go to the University of Michigan. My first job was in a small town in Michigan with 2,000 people. I was the first and only Indian person there at that time. One incident comes to my mind is when I went to a barber shop, the door was locked. When the barber saw me, he let me in and said he heard that I came from India, so he would cut my hair, but he does not even open the door for black people.
Wow, things have changed a lot since my grandparents first came to the U.S. Even though race issues are still a big deal in this country, at least now I know that my story is pretty cool. My grandparents came from villages in third world countries. They moved to the other side of the world for better education, which changed our future forever and made me who I am today. Yes, I am different, but that's fine because everyone's unique, and that's awesome. I'm Taiwanese and Indian, but more importantly, I'm a daughter, a sister, a friend.
An equestrian.
A musician.
An artist.
A chef.
I am American.